Politics, it is a rough game, and no one knows that better than the man Howard Dyshevsky is about to introduce, Mufi Hannemann. Howard?
Right, Joe, thank you very much. Here with the former mayor of the city, county of Honolulu, who you could understand what Neil was talking about when he said the nameplate slides in, it slides out. You've had your name plated in many places, including Washington, D.C., at Honolulu Hall. Of course, Neil Abercrombie, 4 years ago next week, defeated you in the primary, and then he went on to be governor. Here you are, only this time running as an independent. My, how things have changed.
Well, it's all about recognizing that if I were to run for governor again, I had to feel comfortable with the party, and especially with the Democratic Party and the party platform. I've been very grateful to be a Democrat all these years, but the Democratic Party, I believe, in many ways has changed. It's not the party of the working class that I grew up in Kalihi, where our leaders were John Burns and Dan Inouye and George Ariyoshi. And certainly under Neil, it's taken a dramatic shift to the left. And I've always been a moderate, I've always been a centrist, I've always been independent. So I think today what we're representing is where the majority of the people are. In the general election, as many as 100,000 new voters will come out, and those are independents. And I've always done well in general elections. My last two general elections as mayor, I was very privileged to earn the vote in a race where I was able to pull from the Democrats, pull from the Republicans, and then pull from the large middle, the independents.
So to speak in sporting metaphors here, you had the opportunity to watch the first half from the sidelines, kind of be an observer. Now it's halftime, you get to regroup, and I imagine starting tomorrow or Monday at the latest, the second half kicks into full gear. Now you start to get out there with your message. And so if you say you're a little bit disillusioned with the Democratic Party, what new ideas are we going to see come from you, Mufi Hannemann, the independent candidate?
Well, I think, first of all, I want to say congratulations to David Eag. I've known David for a long time. He and I both represent the same impulse in IA. I didn't think my opponent would have been David Eag, to tell you quite frankly. I don't think anybody in this state knew it was going to be David Eag. So he defied the odds, and he certainly deserves a lot of congratulations for all the work that he and his team put forward. But I think in the general election now, the dynamics change. And I think the message tonight was people want their voice to be heard. They want to be respected. They want leaders who are going to respond to it. So going forward, I believe that philosophy, Les Chang and I are very comfortable with. He was part of a winning team that I had at City Hall, an all-star cast. I believe they left the city better than we found it. So now it's all about conveying a message that a family member, a head of a household, a kupuna, a young person can say, he or she is speaking to me. I believe in that. And it's not just about promises, but it's promises that are based on a history of delivering, a history of executive experience of actually doing that job. And in our case, is managing the 13th largest city in the United States.
Well, we wish you the very best of luck. We'll be seeing much more and hearing much more from you as the weeks and months unfold.
Thank you very much.
Mufi Hannemann, who is going to be the independent candidate for governor, along with two other formidable opponents, we wish you the very best.
Thank you, Dash.
All right, Mufi, thank you very much. Joe, we're going to send it back to you.